So all together, four muscles are forming the ham part or back of the thigh. Two muscles are the semi muscles, the semi tendinosus and semi membranosus. The upper part of the muscle is membrane like, so known as semi membranosus, and lower part is fleshy and rounded. The other muscle is having upper part fleshy but lower half is tendon like, so known as semi tendinosus. These two muscles with the long head of the biceps femoris and the ham part of the adductor magnus extend the hip joint and flex the knee joint. So collectively all four muscles of the ham region are extensor for the hip joint and prime mover for the flexion of the knee joint. So day to day walking and day to day working, in casual walking, the extension of the hip is done by these ham muscles, not by gluteus maximus muscle. Gluteus maximus muscle is used only during powerful extension like jumping, climbing the stair, climb the mountains. The third muscle of the region, which is having two heads, so known as biceps femoris, a long head taking origin from the lower medial half of the upper quadrilateral part of the ischial tuberosity with the semi tendinosus. Covering the two muscles and having a short head also, which is taking origin from the femur. So two heads of the biceps, a long head and a short head. The long head is arising from the ischial tuberosity with the semi tendinosus running downwards and laterally to join the short head of the biceps femoris, which is arising from the femur. So inserted on the head of the fibula, some fibers are also inserted on the crural fascia. The upper part of the muscle is covering the semi membranosus muscle when it is running from the lower medial half of the upper quadrilateral space of the ischial tuberosity, and it is also covering a big nerve, the sciatic nerve, which is coming out from this space. From the greater sciatic foramen below the piriformis muscle. The piriformis muscle is the key muscle of this region, some structures are coming out or enter in the pelvic cavity below the muscle. Altogether, 8 structures are running below the piriformis, and superior gluteal vessels and nerves are above the piriformis muscle. So, nerve is running down here. When we see the course of the nerve, this is the sciatic nerve. When we go for intramuscular injection, we should avoid this muscle to prevent the traumatic neuritis. It should be traced between the skull tuberosity and the greater trochanter of the femur. So, surface anatomy of the sciatic nerve is between the skull tuberosity and greater trochanter of the femur. Muscle is covered, the nerve is covered by gluteus maximus muscle, and then it is running under cover of the long head of the biceps femoris. Then nerve is running on the adductor magnus muscle. The nerve is coming from L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3. L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3. These are anterior divisions of the ventral primary rami of L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3, and some fibers derived from posterior division of L4, L5, S1, S2 only. So, the fibers from L4, L5